Deputy Claire Daly.
Thanks, Cian Corla. Taoiseach, when the Commission of Investigation, which ultimately became the Charlton Tribunal, was first discussed, myself and Deputy Wallace moved an amendment to the terms of reference to include an investigation into the extent to which the Minister for Justice had been briefed about Maurice McCabe. In March, when the Disclosures Tribunal was set up, we wrote to Justice Charlton to specifically ask him to investigate under terms of reference H, which you quoted earlier, contact between An Garda Síochána and staff in the Department of Justice. And I have to say, anyone who's surprised that evidence of the involvement of the Department of Justice exists really hasn't been paying attention to what's gone on in terms of the crisis of policing in this state over the past number of years, and its roots in the link between An Garda Síochána, the Department of Justice and the Minister for Justice, a link which we sought to break in legislation which we moved in terms of proper independent oversight, which unfortunately was not supported by the House. So the real question for you, Taoiseach, it's not that the crisis is going to have a knock-on effect on the Department of Justice, but rather, why is that information being released now through the offices of your former cabinet colleague, whose party supported Noreen O'Sullivan 100%, not just in government, but indeed in opposition, after the revelations of her legal strategy in relation to Maurice McCabe had been exposed? And of course, critically, what are you going to do about it? Because you've fared pretty well out of Garda controversies, but now you're the boss, and the calling on this is solely a matter for you. And you can choose to either be a pawn in the games being played by the warring tribes that exist inside An Garda Síochána, with the Department of Justice mandarins in the background, or you can decide to take decisive action in terms of delivering a modern police service that the citizens and the Gardaí deserve. Taoiseach, last week, senior Garda officers attending a pre-retirement course were shocked to see none other than the acting Garda Commissioner amble in and sit himself down to hear the talk that was unfolding when they thought he was leading from the helm. The same acting Garda Commissioner whose report into allegations of Garda involvement in the heroin trade in the constituency of the Minister for Justice has not been published for 3.5 years, as a result of which GSOC can't publish their report, they having previously been stopped from attending the disciplinary action into these Gardaí, and indeed from having their access to files being frustrated. My questions to you, Taoiseach, are how can there be change without accountability or effective oversight? And how long are you going to allow this situation to prevail? We have the Commission on Policing flopping around on the outskirts, coming up with nice jargon about new uniforms and new words. But how in God's name is the chaos going to be stopped when there's no one at the helm? What other company with 15,000 members of staff wouldn't have a CEO in place? What job does it take to fill? Taoiseach, for God's sake, when are you going to call for the implementation of the Garda Inspectorate report and the fulfilling of the vacancy for Garda Commissioner?
Thank you, Deputy Taoiseach.
Thanks very much, Deputy. The process of Garda reform is very much underway. We have an acting Garda Commissioner. I met him just last week. He's not retiring, by the way, and he will be in place until we're in a position to recruit a new Garda Commissioner, which we intend to do as soon as possible, and discussions are underway with the Commission on the Future of Policing and also the Policing Authority to make that happen, because I think it is important that we have a new Garda Commissioner in place sooner rather than later, and that new Commissioner is able to bring in his or her own team, because I don't think one person on their own can change the Gardaí. And I had the opportunity when I was in Seattle the week before last to speak with Kathleen O'Toole, who told me her story about how she reformed and modernised the Seattle Police Service. And she said to me that it was somewhat similar to what we had in Ireland, with Gardaí running IT systems, running HR, running things that policemen aren't really best trained to do, and how important it was that the new commissioner, once appointed, are able to bring in their own team as well as that. I think it may be worth informing the House that A memo was brought to the Cabinet this morning by the Minister for Justice to give the Policing Authority approval for the first time to appoint a Superintendent of the Gardaí who is a member of the PSNI. And that is a very practical example of reform underway. For the first time, somebody from an outside police force, in this case somebody from Northern Ireland, from the PSNI, being appointed to a senior position in the Gardaí. So that's an outside appointment to a senior position. And I think you'll see more of that in the weeks and months ahead. In relation to some of your other questions, I really can't answer questions on behalf of third parties who are not members of this House or former members of this House. They would have to be directed to them. And also, I'd like the House to be aware that we should be circumspect when commenting on matters before a tribunal. And as parliamentarians, we need to bear that in mind when making public comment. We need to respect the role of the tribunal, which was established by the Oireachtas earlier this year. And all sides of the House supported the establishment of that tribunal, and all members were given an opportunity at that time to contribute to its terms of reference. And the standing orders of this House, as the Count Corla will know, preclude members from raising matters which encroach on the work of the tribunal.
Thank you, Taoiseach. Deputy
Thanks, Count Corla. Well, we fully respect the work of Justice Charlton, and in fact the record will bear witness to that. We have been in contact with him. But what's unfolding here now is people, and there is a crisis of policing in this state, and a drowning man or woman will grab on to anyone to try and save themselves. That could be a senior civil servant, it could be a minister. The question for you is it going to be you? And quite frankly, your answer is not the answer you would have given when you were a minister and not the Taoiseach. Because the issue at stake is who is going to seize control that's going on. Measures such as the appointment of people in other police service have been long recommended by the Garda Inspectorate. We need an implementation of these measures. And presumably you, who would probably bask in the glory of your new leadership and the benefit that has been to Fine Gael with the same members, the same party, yet the perception is different. Presumably a new leader for An Garda Síochána could be the transforming vehicle that they need, because they need something. Because what's going on now is warring tribes in anticipation of the Charlton Tribunal. And if you honestly think that that can survive until the Commission on Policing may decide to give us an answer in a year's time, well, then I'm sorry,
Thank
but
you,
you're
Deputy.
More deluded than I gave you credit for before.
Taoiseach.
You're absolutely right, Deputy. I actually don't disagree with the analysis you've put forward. I'm not sure I'd go as far as warring tribes, but the solutions you're putting forward and the change that needs to happen, I think I broadly agree with. And I gave you an example of the change that is happening. For the first time, somebody from outside, a member of the PSNI, being appointed as a superintendent, and that was agreed by Cabinet this morning. We also have a civilianisation process underway. You'll be aware that a number of senior posts in the Gardaí are now being filled by civilians. We have the Policing Authority and we have the Policing Commission. And certainly we will not be waiting for the Policing Commission to produce its final report before we recruit a new Garda Commissioner. We need a new Garda Commissioner, and we need that new Garda Commissioner to be able to bring in people from outside the force to modernise it and improve it and bring it up to the standard that we expect. And it is we do anticipate, it's not fully under control of government, the Policing Authority has a role in this now as well, but we do anticipate, and it is our intention as a government, to advertise for the position of Garda Commissioner before the end of this calendar year.
Thank you, Taoiseach.